Bonjour tout le monde, je suis content de vous voir pour la leçon 17. Cette leçon est vraiment importante parce qu'aujourd'hui, on va s'intéresser au prétérit et au pronom d'objet. Le prétérit va vous être très utile pour parler de ce que vous avez fait dans le passé, alors que les pronoms d'objet vont vous aider à remplacer des noms dans vos phrases. Alors, pour mettre un verbe au prétérit, c'est-à-dire au passé, vous allez premièrement choisir un pronom et ensuite un verbe auquel il faut ajouter la terminaison ed. Ok, ed, we say in English. All right, so I'll write it. Ed, just like that. Ok, ed. Ok. Ici, vous pouvez voir qu'on a les verbes suivants. So we have to watch. Ok, to watch is like regarder, surveiller. Ok, and in the past we say watched. Like this, with ed, watched. And then we have greet, is like hello, hi, saluer, okay, accueillir. Greeted is in the past, greeted. Then we have look, regarder, and you can say looked, okay, looked, looked. To use, utiliser, and in the past we say used. Used. To call, like to call on the phone, appeler. To call, and we can say called. To try, okay? To try is like essayer, okay? To try, and we say tried. T-R-I-E-D, okay? T-R-I-E-D. And then we have to need. To need is like avoir besoin de. Okay, and in the past we say needed. Okay, needed. Watch, to greet, to look, to use, to call, to try, and to need. Si l'on ajoute ed à la fin de ce verbe, like right here, à la fin, ed, watched, greeted, looked, used, called, tried, and then needed, okay, on obtient le prétérit, okay, c'est-à-dire le passé du verbe. So, ça, c'est le passé. Watched, greeted, looked, used, called, tried, and then needed. Okay? So, examinons quelques exemples ici. Okay, with a past simple. I blinked TV last night. I, what are you gonna say from here? I watched, right? I watched. W-A-T-C-H-E-D. J'ai regardé la télé hier soir. Right? I watched TV last night. You blink me at the door. So, à la porte. So, at the door, we're going to say you greeted. Greeted. So, we say you greeted me at the door. Tu m'as salué à la porte. He, her with suspicion. So, what can we say here? He blank her with suspicion. He watched her with suspicion. He greeted her to look. He looked at her. Yes, looked. Okay. He looked at her with suspicion. Okay. Il a regardé avec suspicion. Right? He looked at her, the girl, with suspicion. We blanked them last week. Okay, we watched them last week, greeted them last week, looked at them, used them, called them. We haven't used called, so we'll say we called with ed. Okay, le passé. We called them last week. So it's like on les a appelés la semaine dernière, last week. Et finalement, on a they blank help with their homework. They so needed, right? We could say needed. They needed. So they needed, elles ont eu help, besoin, okay, with their homework. So they needed help with their homework. Elles ont eu besoin d'aide avec leur devoir. So they needed help with their homework. Même si la plupart des verbes suivent le même modèle, il existe beaucoup d'autres verbes couramment employés dont la forme doit être mémorisée. So you have to memorize it. Okay? On va maintenant examiner les formes du passé de quelques verbes irréguliers, so irregular verbs, pour ensuite en formuler des phrases. Okay? So here we have irregular verbs. Okay? To be. Okay? So to be is être. Être en français, to be, was and were, okay, I was, j'étais, were, okay, so it's like, I was, you were, okay, he, she was, they were, okay, pour ce verbe, vous devez vous rappeler de chacune de ces formes, I was, you were, he, she, it was, we were, and they were. Then we have to have, avoir, and in the past, we have it as had, okay? Had. To do is faire. So faire is to do is did, okay? Did. To say is dire. Dire. To say, and we say said, okay? To go, aller, went. To get, okay? To get is like, well, to get can mean several things, but to get means chercher, okay, to get, and we say got. To make, okay, is like faire, and we say made. To know, savoir, or connaître, knew. To think, penser, thought. Okay, remember, these are irregular, okay, irregular verbs. To take, prendre, took. To come, okay, venir, came. In the past, came. To find is trouver, found. In the past tense, found, in the irregular form. To give somebody something, donner. We say gave, okay? To tell means two things. Ça veut dire to tell. Ça veut dire dire, right? To tell, okay? Dire quelque chose or raconter, right? So to tell a story, for example, raconter, okay? To tell, and we say told in the past. So I told him something. He told me this. Blah blah blah. Okay, raconter. To become, devenir, and then we say became. To see, voir. Oopsie, I put voir en français. Okay, to see, saw. Okay, and then to feel is like ressentir, and we say felt. I felt happy. I felt sad. Ressentir. Okay. So here we have all irregular verbs, okay? Irregular verbs here. All right, so voilà donc les formes du passé irrégulières que vous devez mémoriser. Okay, passons maintenant rapidement au pronom d'objet. Nous avons ici me. Okay, do you know what me means? Me. Me. Okay, me is like moi. Okay, we say me, moi. You, okay, like you. Okay, so toi or vous. I'll put it here. Toi, vous. Him, okay, him is lui. Her, elle. It, us. Okay, us is like nous. Nous. And then we have them. Them is like or elle, right? Them, okay? All right, so me, you, him, her, it, us, and them. Rappelez-vous qu'un pronom d'objet est le destinataire de l'action et non l'auteur de l'action, okay? So, Object pronouns, okay? Voici quelques phrases contenant le prétérit et des noms, des pronoms d'objets. Here's some examples. Number one. I was very excited to meet them. I was very excited to meet them. J'étais vraiment ému de les voir. Okay? J'étais vraiment ému de les voir. Okay? I was excited to see them. I was excited to meet them. Okay? You could say. You had two gifts under the Christmas tree last year. Okay? You had two gifts under the Christmas tree last year. Tu avais deux cadeaux sous l'arbre de Noël l'an passé. Okay? Last year. She did everything possible not to get sick. Okay? Elle a tout fait pour ne pas devenir malade. Okay? She did everything possible to not get sick. We said sorry to him. Okay? We said sorry to him. Nous lui avons présenté nos excuses. They went out with you last night? It's a question. C'est une question. So, they went out with you last night? Okay, so, elles sont sorties avec toi la nuit dernière. I got the wine for her. Okay, I got the wine for her. J'ai acheté le vin pour elle. And then, you made breakfast for me. Okay, so you made breakfast for me right here. You made breakfast for me. Tu as fait le petit déjeuner pour moi. He knew the answer to it. Okay, he knew the answer to it. Il en savait la réponse. Okay, he knew the answer to it. We thought about it. We thought about it. Nous y avons pensé. They came to visit us. So, ils sont venus nous rendre visite. I found money under it. Okay, so j'ai trouvé de l'argent en dessous. You gave me it, or you could say, you gave it to me. Okay, tu me l'as donné. Right? You gave me it. You gave it to me. He told them to go home. Il leur a dit d'aller à la maison. We felt the earthquake last November. Okay? So, nous avons ressenti le tremblement de terre en novembre dernier. Okay? Last November. And finally, they became best friends. They became best friends. Ils sont devenus meilleurs amis. They became best friends. Eh bien, tout le monde, c'est tout pour cette leçon d'aujourd'hui. Je sais que c'était un peu difficile d'apprendre tous ces verbes irréguliers au début, mais avec le temps, je suis confiant que vous serez en mesure de les mémoriser. Chaque fois que vous rencontrerez un nouveau verbe, je vous recommande de trouver comment le conjuguer et de répéter ses formes à plusieurs reprises. En tous les cas, j'espère que ce n'était pas trop difficile pour vous aujourd'hui. Assurez-vous de cliquer j'aime et de vous abonner. On se voit dans la prochaine leçon. See you next time. Bye!